studying?
Theater. Need to do a report on some aspect of theater.
Hey!
I don't even know anything about theater.
We've been in plays before, we can help you out.
Yeah, I know what I'm gonna do though. It's all really boring.
What plays are you reading? Most plays are hilarious.
Really? Like what?
Well, most plays are about sex.
What? Dude, I can't talk about sex in school.
Oh, come on. My theater teacher showed me a video of this dude dressed up as a penis. It'll be fine.
Well, sure. Where do we start?
Baby.
We head to ancient Greece, where sexuality was found most readily in the Greek gods and goddesses. Zeus, the most powerful of the Greek gods, was well known for his sexual impulses. His wife, Hera, however, was not amused.
Jeez, go away.
Due to this unfortunate situation, many plays were written about the illegitimate children of Zeus. Some of these children include Apollo and Artemis, Athena, who was born from Zeus's forehead, and Dionysus, who's born from Zeus's inner thigh. Dionysus was the god of natural fluids.
Like semen.
And wine. Which is why he was also known as the god of theater. When people got drunk.
And had sex.
And acted weird. It was compared to when actors pretend to be someone else on stage. Thus, he became the god of theater. Apollo was also the god of theater, but he was in charge of order in the theater.
Not sex.
Yes, not sex. Another famous Greek play was Oedipus Tyrannus by Sophocles. Oedipus learns from the oracle that he will one day kill his father and marry his mother. To prevent this, he runs away from home to protect his parents. But unfortunately for Oedipus, he was adopted. On the road away from his adopted father, he meets his real father. His real father turns out to be a jerk and tries to kill him, but Oedipus kills him in self-defense. Oedipus also meets a sphinx and solves a riddle, saving the town. The town graciously gives him their queen. After marrying the queen, we find out that she is actually his mom. The queen suddenly becomes hysteric after learning this and hangs herself. Oedipus becomes equally hysteric and stabs out his eyes. The end! After the fall of Rome, theater took a turn for the non-existent. The church now controlled all of theater, and the theater they put out was extremely void of sexuality. One playwright, however, did have some sex in her plays.
You know what's wrong with women these days? Too much sex. Yeah, you know, we don't need any more sluts in this world, God knows that. So, I decided to write 6 plays. The first 3 are going to be about virginal women. The second 3 are going to be about sinful women. In the first 3, it's going to be a virginal woman who meets a man who's trying to dishonor her through sex. Alright? But she refuses him. But she feels so bad, she repents. She feels like she's done something bad, so she dies. And then, in the next 3 plays, about the sinful women, they're going to meet a man, and they're going to try and tempt him with evil sexual acts. And they're going to feel so bad about it, and they're going to repent, and they die. But the good news is everybody goes to heaven at the end.
Then came the Renaissance playwrights. One of the most well-known playwrights of all times, Shakespeare, also had sexuality play a main role in his works. One of his works, As You Like It, written in the middle of his career, portrays the ambiguity of sexuality and the dangers of love.
Oh me, my love is gone, he's a Montague.
Du Bois.
A cruel, cruel world where I have to go into the woods and dress as a man.
With
Hey there, sexy. What you doing in this neck of the woods?
I'm so gay, I love men. Have you seen Orlando?
That's okay. Homosexuality can be cured with ritualistic prayer and fasting. And Orlando, he's right over there being a mopey pants. See you later.
No.
I hate my life.
Hey. What's wrong? What's up, bro?
I can't marry the woman I love because she's a Capulet.
Friedrich.
Whatever. It doesn't matter anymore. She's gone.
She'll come back to you. And cry. And I'm sure she's not gonna want you crawling on the floor like a dog when she's left her family for you. And between you and me, man, between two men here, I'm sure she's gonna want sex.
Really? You think so?
Yeah.
Yeah! Woo! Sex! All right. I have a good feeling about this.
Maybe we should practice. I'll be Rosalind so you know what to do.
Alright. You make a hot babe. Are you sure you're not gay?
Actually, I don't know. You want to test this theory?
Sure.
I'm actually Rosalind. Have sex with me now!
No!
So everyone got married. Rosalind and Orlando married each other. Celie found Orlando's hot friend, and they got married. Phoebe finally married a poor bloke who had been courting her forever.
Bazinga! Damn it!
And two random people named Audrey and Touchstone married so that they could have sex.
Sex!
And then all marriages were consummated. One final thing from this time period, a Frenchman named Jean-Baptiste Louis created ballet so that King Louis XVI could show off his legs.
This feels amazing!
Finally, we head to the era of modern theater. Here we begin to see people expressing their sexual frustrations through theater. In 1944, Jean-Paul Sartre wrote a play titled No Exit that describes frustrating relationships with other people.
What the hell is this place?
I don't know, but it sucks. Could use some paint.
Let's all sit down.
So, this is hell, huh? I abandoned my troops and cheated on my wife. And I'm stuck here? I could get used to it. What'd you two do?
I killed my baby by drowning him.
Killed my cousin after having an affair with his wife. Sure.
Not you, him!
No.
Will you have sex with me?
Yes.
Shut up! Not you, her!
No!
Please?
No.
Please?
No!
Please?
No. I don't think so.
Will you tell me I'm brave?
Shut up!
Hell is other people.
Americans take their newfound sexuality and run with it, putting on such plays as Spring Awakenings.
God, I'm so horny. Got me a devil in my pants. Don't worry, dude. Wrote you an essay on sex. It'll explain everything. Thanks, man. Yeah, no problem. I gotta go meet my childhood friend.
What?
What is sex?
Oh, that's... Oh, yeah. Oh, crap. Man, I suck.
No, I do.
What?
Give me sex.
What?
Give me sex.
No. No! Okay, wait. I'll have sex. Damn, I suck. Oh well. Cyanide pill. All right.
pregnant?
Don't worry, I'll take it out.
Okay.
Alright. You got Wendella pregnant.
We had sex? Oh my gosh, I gotta go be a dad. I gotta go find Wendella. Wendella, let's get married. Oh, what? A gravestone? For Wendella? No! Suicide time!
No, don't do it!
What? Ghosts of my two dead friends? You don't want me to commit suicide?
No. No.
Okay!
Back home, folks! Wow, that was awesome. Never knew theater could be so fun. I think I will do my project on it, and teacher's sure to give me an A.
Well, good luck. We have other friends that we're gonna go play sports with because they love us.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, we're really popular and awesome.
Bye!
Bye!
See ya!
Sides fall out, yeah. 'Cause when you're being fucked with to no end, suddenly the walls are starting to close in, close in, close in, because you're brainwashed, yeah. You are brainwashed. So